everyone. I am Chantilly Jagannath.
I'm Amarendra Dundala.
And we are
mad.
Hashtag mad. Millennials and Data. We are excited to bring you episode three of our blog series. This one we are not doing a actual visualization. We're not designing something per se from start to finish, but it will be more of a tips and tricks that was actually requested by the community. So thank you for requesting one of our
Shout out to Rajiv Pandey, who actually reached out to us and asked if we can actually record the whole process of using Google Sheets.
Yes.
So Rajiv, thank you. This video.
Yes, this video is really for you and everyone else in the community that asks. So have you ever been in a meeting and you know, you're the one hosting the meeting and you pass around this form and say, hey, can everybody sign in? That sucks, I'll tell you. Sitting in the crowd and actually having to fill out a piece of paper, chances are I don't even bring a pen.
Gonna type in all of that in an Excel sheet and then visualize it, right?
No, yeah, that's another thing too. Yeah. Or who's gonna have to write down each of those
waste
email
of
addresses?
Paper, waste of time, waste of effort.
Yeah, so what Amara and I do for all of our meetings that we host, especially our Millennials and Data Info sessions, is we have our students or our participants or our attendees fill out a Google form that pretty much collects their first name, their last name, as you see right here, the form. It collects their first name, their last name, their email address, and we get them engaged by asking them some type of icebreaker question. So 9 times out of 10, we're showing the students or somebody new something new about Tableau, and we want to get them engaged. So we'll ask them, hey, what's your favorite social media account or app? How are you liking the weather outside? Or just something fun to get them engaged, right? And then from there, we've implemented this new QR code section. Mm-hmm. So instead of actually putting the link on the screen.
Often what we observed is even from a few sessions that we have attended, the link is shown on the slides and they ask you to manually put in the link. And sometimes we miss a slash or we miss a letter, and then it's annoying. Where I personally, maybe I'll try it twice, and the third time I'll be like, I'll just pass it on.
Yeah.
So using a QR code is, whoever is your audience, you just have to scan it, and they have this.
Yes. So we got this feedback from the community as well to implement the QR code. So we're gonna do that in the demo. And from there, the responses are collected in a Google Sheet. And the last part of it is the connection to Tableau, the Google Sheets connection to Tableau. It's where you can collect all of your attendees' data, which sounds kind of creepy at first, but...
No, what's cool about this is Tableau has an inbuilt Google Sheet connector as well. I think most of you are aware of that, but
Yeah, so once you do that, you collect their responses, you'll have their email addresses in the background, which you won't let them see, and then you'll visualize it, get an engaged audience, and go from there. Yeah. So we'll walk you through exactly how to do each four of these steps in about 5 to 10 minutes, and if you have any comments, questions, or feedback, definitely let us know down below, let us know on Twitter, and everything that you need to know will be placed in the description.
With that, let's get started.
Alrighty, so getting started with creating a form, you go to your Google Drive account, and within your Google Drive account, you'll select New, you will select More, and you will do a Google form. Here, we'll make it really simple. We'll say sample form, right? Then the first thing you always ask your participants to do is to provide their name. I realize that sometimes you have to specify first name and last name because for some reason people just don't believe them spelling.
I mean, I think also in most forms, both of them are two different fields, first name and last name.
But I don't even want to get, we don't have to get too particular here. I just realized, you know, experiences have taught us to specify that you need both the first name and the last name. Alrighty, we'll leave that as a short answer, make it required, add a new question. This one can be email. You can enable the email collection setting. I usually don't because that requires sometimes people having to sign into their Google account. And we don't want that, not in this instance. So we have their name, we have their email address, and then another one is, we could say like, how Look, and Google was smart. It did a 1-to-5. no, that's not what we want. What do we want? We'll do...
I think we can go with
the... We could do a drop down.
Not at all.
No.
This meeting sucks.
somewhat. Neutral.
Yeah.
And very. All right. And then we'll do one more question that says, what is your favorite social media?
Okay.
Yeah, account. I don't know. It just came to mind.
Social media app?
I mean, how do you know everybody has an app, though?
I mean, these days everything is called an app, so.
Facebook, Twitterverse, or the Twitter.
Instagram,
Snapchat, and that's it for now. Yeah. Nothing complicated. Make everything required, right? And now you have your 4 sample questions. The next thing you want to do is responses. And in this response section, this is where you'll see all of the responses, but this green icon right here lets you send all of your responses to a spreadsheet, which is essentially what you need in order to connect it to Tableau. So if you click this, you'll say select spreadsheet, and you can create a new spreadsheet, and we will call this one sample form responses, and it will automatically save to your Google Drive account. You don't have to create this part. Say create, you're accepting responses, and now the next thing you want to do is press send. And in this send window, you'll see a link. So this link is what you will use to send everyone to your form, but in this instance we want to use this link as the basis for our QR code. So what you'll do is you will copy the link, and I already have a window up called qrdroid.com. It's one of the QR code generators that allows you to increase or decrease the size of your QR code. Google's is automatically 200 by 200.
Mm-hmm.
This one, you can do it a little bit larger so that your participants or whoever can see it. So you go to QR code generator, you input your URL code, you specify how big you want it, we'll do 350 by 350, and you generate the code. And boom, there it is right there. So then you'll take that and you'll save image as, and we're going to save ours in the documents, new folder, survey draft. We'll save it there, and I'll name it QR code. Right?
Yeah.
Press save. Now you have your QR code, you have your form, and you automatically have your Google
Sheet
selected.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So now the next thing we will do is we will go to Tableau. In the Tableau window, you can connect to Google Sheets as an option. Select Google Sheets. It'll take you to your verification window. Ours is under our Millennials and Data account. Select Allow. It'll let you know that this was only for authentication purposes, so now you can close this. Go back to Tableau, and Tableau asks you which
Sylvia, or which Google Sheet?
Yeah, which Google Sheet you want to connect to. See it here. Oh, you know what you have to do first? You actually have to get a response. So if we go back and we preview it, preview, and we fill this out. my real email address if you want to email me. I'm very excited. And I'm grammar, actually. And you submit the response, and now the Google Sheet is actually in your Google Drive right here. It's been created. So now, once we go back to Tableau, I'll just reconnect.
Isn't that the
That's what I was saying.
I think it's taking your account name.
It's under the Millennials and Data account.
What was the first one?
The different Millennials and Data account. We have a million. There it is. Side story. This is the Gmail account for Millennials and Data. Alrighty, so now in your Tableau workbook, you will see all of the fields that you have. So we will do number of records. You see that there's one respondent. That's what they're called?
Respondent. I think
E-N-T. One response. Increase the size of this.
Bold it.
You have one response so far. Number of responses. And then here you will have, usually you don't display the email addresses, but the next thing you can do is show how excited individuals are. We just have one for right now, right? Alrighty, so you have your number of responses, everybody's a one. Then you go back here, right? So let me go to my images and pull up that QR code. Alrighty, so here's the QR code, and I've installed a QR code reader on my phone. If you have iOS 11 or...
You can directly do it from your camera app.
I don't know how Androids work. I'm team iPhone all day. So anyways, exactly. So what happens with this is you open up the app right here. It grabs the picture. And as you can see, it takes you to the form. I'm going to quickly fill out the form with the Mars information. Alrighty, so we put in a couple of responses for our Visit Philly crew. So we did Pooja, we did Adam, we did Josh, Tom,
Corey,
Omar, and myself. Mm-hmm. So we've done all that. So say you're in a meeting or you're hosting a meeting and you want all of your attendees to fill this form out. Everybody fills out their form. Now you will go to the Tableau dashboard. You will select data, go down to it, select refresh. It's automatically connected to the Google Form. So now you can see that we have 7 responses. Everybody's very excited for this meeting. We have some ties on the favorite social media apps, Instagram, Snapchat, and Twitter. And you know, this is something that can really get your audience engaged and wanting them to learn more, especially if you're having a meeting on data or definitely about Tableau. And what's really neat is that in the background of this, what they don't see is now you have all of their email addresses, which in this instance is mostly mine because I placed my email address on there for everyone. So you see 6 people have Chantilly's email address, and then we have a few at Millennials and Data. And now you don't have to ask your attendees, or you know, you don't have to say, hey, fill out this piece of paper with your information. You have that, you have the QR code that everybody can access using their phone, whether it's an iPhone or an Android, and now you have a really neat dashboard to get them engaged with.
We do this all the time, and it's really fun when it's done in between a lot of people in real time.
Exactly.
So now you know how to do it, so hopefully we think that you'll use it often.
Exactly. And we will put the links down below for anything that we've shown you. So we'll do the link for the Google Forms,
mm-hmm.
we'll do the link for the Google Sheets, and we'll do it for the QR code
yep.
generator as well. If you have any questions, any comments, any feedback, comment down below. Definitely subscribe and look out for our next video. Hope you enjoy.
See ya.
See you.